Today, we're taking a look at the torque seating monitoring tightening strategy available on the Atlas Copco MicroTorque Focus 6000 controller. Let's see how it works. If I were to screw these two blocks together, they should stay stuck together. What is keeping them from separating is clamp force. To create clamp force, we must first seat the screw, eliminating any gaps in our assembly. Once seated, the controller will detect the change in torque and recognize that the seating point has been met. The final torque is still being calculated this entire time, but now a secondary reading begins from this point. Any torque applied after the seating occurs is now generating clamp force. The final torque is a count of the entire fastening procedure, while the clamp torque is only counted after seating. By understanding what we are assembling, we could input values for what an acceptable final and clamp torque is. The strategy can help eliminate floating screws, thread stripping, and broken parts while dealing with a large variety of materials. It also ensures consistent clamp force across a series of tightenings, giving you the confidence that your assemblies will stay assembled. Here is a Pset that's set up for torque seating monitoring. The first step is an angle step that will rotate the screw 100 degrees to help the screw start to thread before the next step. We could also replace it with a thread engagement step if the process needed it. The second step is a torque seating monitoring step. For this specific Pset, I am aiming for a target torque of 10 centinewton meters. My minimum clamp torque is 4.5 centinewton meters, and my max clamp torque is 7 centinewton meters. If we reach our seating torque between 3 and 5.5 centinewton meters of force, we should achieve enough clamp torque before we hit our limit of 10 centinewton meters. Let's see the Pset in action now. I have it all set up and we're going to be putting screws into this board where I have the size holes that are meant for this Pset, and I also have some holes that aren't the right size, so we'll see how those differ. It's the first screw going down. Alright, we got the OK signal. You can see that our seating point occurred at 4.6 centinewton meters. We applied 5.41 centinewton meters of clamp torque for a final torque of 10.01. There was no tightening error, so that field is going to remain blank for us. And if we look on our graph on our computer through ToolsTalk MicroTorque, we can see that we have our graph showing the entire tightening while the screw was being seated. It recognized the seating point occurred right here at 4.6 as the torque ramps up very quickly and we're generating that clamp force. And then we hit our final torque of 10.1. Our clamp torque is 5.4, which is perfectly within the bounds of our Pset. Let's do another screw, and we'll watch the trace in real time. All right, another successful tightening. Very consistent with the last one, this time seating at 4.6. This one seating at 5.2. But again, still within the Pset specifications that we set before. If you have a tighter tolerance, it'll be harder to achieve it, but that's up to you as you program the tool. Let's see what happens now if I run down on the other side of this board on these holes, which aren't the same size as these holes. We're going to get some different results here. Now this hole is much tighter, so what happens here is the seating point didn't occur until 5.75. which means that our clamp torque was only 4.3. Now, we get the error here saying that our clamp torque was low. That's because we set a minimum value of 4.5 for our clamp torque. These holes, since they're tighter, are going to offer more resistance. More of the torque is being wasted in seating the screw, and it doesn't get to apply that torque to actually making clamp force because we're still stopping at 10 centinewton meters. Let's try it again and see if we get a different result. Same problem. We applied way too much torque reaching our seating point that we didn't have enough left to generate that clamp torque. As we could see on our graph here, it's having much harder time seating that screw as the torque will raise much higher. Before we were seating at 4.5, now we're seating at 6.5. I'll do another fastening on the right size holes. See how that works. Perfect. Now, if I were to back this screw out and try to re-hit the same hole twice, it's going to have a slightly larger diameter than it did the first time, so we may not generate, or we might generate too much clamp force. Let's see. Nope, it was still okay. Although we are reaching our upper limits really soon. What happens if I do it again? Yeah, so now, because we've run down the same hole three times, we've been stripping it each time. And what happens now is our seeding point happens very quickly, and we applied way too much clamp force. For this specific joint now, we could say that it would fail since it's not up to standard with the rest of them. And that's how easy it is to set up a torque seating monitoring Pset and really get a good idea of what's going on in your joint. Clamp force is very important when we're trying to keep things stuck together. And if you have a product that can be damaged if you apply too much torque, then it's important to know how much torque is being applied to clamp force and how much is being used just to seat the screw onto the surface and get all your parts stuck together. If you're interested in checking this out yourself, you could find all the information on the MT Focus on our website. And if you like this video, please feel free to subscribe and sign up for alerts, as we will be doing more videos and demonstrations in the future. I'm Steve from Flexible Assembly. Thank you for watching, and as always, have a great day.